If you look at this definition, data communication, I mean, is partly, partly involves telecommunication. Okay, data communication involves telecommunication. Tele means far, so using telephone technology, which is which overcomes the barriers in communication, and then plus data. In other words, we are sending data over this network, telephone network. Okay, so when I say telephone network, it may be any kind of telephone network. So it is a data communication is a combination of data and telecommunication. Now, when we said tele, it means far. It means we are sending data as far as possible. Now, what is data? We have been defining this data. Now, let's look at data from the point of data communication. Data is facts or information in the form, this is very important, agreed upon by those who create and use it. That means when you have data, there is an idea of sharing it among more than one user. So anybody who is involved in sharing data, they should agree to it that data should be in a certain format. Okay, the form should be, they should agree on what format it should be, or what data type it should be, and all of those, what structure it should be. So when you bring all of those together, the format is agreed upon, then only you can communicate data. Therefore, in data communication, it is very important that the format or the forms of data through which communication takes place is agreed upon by all parties who are involved in the communication, or within that communication system, all participating entities should agree upon the a common standard of data formats. Now, data communication, as we said, it involves telecommunication plus data, is exchange of data. Okay, exchange of data between two devices. Through what? Through a transmission medium. This transmission medium is what we call usually telecommunication. Now, it may or it may not involve telecommunication. For example, the data that you share, that your system or your PC or your mobile within the internal, or the one that's shared internally, does not involve telecommunication. But it definitely involves transmission medium. So it is sharing or exchange of data between, between two devices with the help of some transmission medium. So the communication devices, that means the devices which are exchanging data, okay, the devices which are exchanging data should be a part of the communication system. So it means that we have a communication system. So within this communication system, there are so many devices which are sharing the data. So all these devices which are sharing the data should be a part of a communication system. Now, if I have a device which is outside of this communication system, which means that this is not connected to any of this system, then data cannot be shared with these devices which is outside of a communication system. So when you are setting up multiple devices to be able to share or exchange data, that means you are setting up a communication system. So a communication system will be a combination of both hardware and software. So with the help of this hardware and software, you cannot share, you can share data, You cannot share data only with hardware, or you cannot do it only with software. So it has to be a combination of hardware and software, which is rather complicated or a complex arrangement, which ultimately form the communication system. Now, in order to have a proper communication, the communication needs to be effective. Effective in the sense that communication should be able to take place without any disturbances, or should be data should be effectively communicated. To have that kind of effective communication, it depends on this certain facts. For example, if the communication is ineffective, then there is no communication. So that we have to keep in mind, that having an effective communication and not having an effective communication, there is a big difference between the two. Because when communication is ineffective, it is as good as not having communication. So in order to have the effective communication, first important thing is delivery. These are the criteria for having effective communication. So the communication system must deliver the data correctly. That means if the data that is delivered is A, B, and C, so when it is delivered, it should be A, B, and C, not X, Y, Z. Then, in that case, when A, B, C is sent, it is delivered as X, Y, Z, then the delivery, there is some flaw in the delivery mechanism. Therefore, there is a problem. You cannot have a communication. Now, whenever I said something, you understand something else. We cannot have a communication. So even in verbal communication also, if I say, the words I say should be the words that you understand as a person, as the destination or the person who received the communication. Otherwise, if I say something and you understand something else, we cannot have communication. So therefore, delivery is very important, and the data must be correctly delivered in the form and the sequence in which it is intended. So, and another thing is that the delivery should be, if this information ABC is, let us say, these devices, COM1 is sending it to COM2, okay? So it should be only COM2 that receive the intended destination. It should be only COM2 that receive the communication. When COM1 is sending to COM2, it should not be received by COM3 or 4 or 5. So that is also correct delivery of the data. Now, coming to accuracy, the system must deliver the data accurately. So this is more or less about the correctness of the data. Data can be altered in transmission. Okay. Sometimes while the data is being delivered, we said that communication normally takes place between A and B, and through some form of medium. So there will be some intermediate mediums also that helps A and B to have a proper communication. So therefore, when a data is being altered, there are chances of data that we transmit being altered somewhere here, or somewhere in the, even in the medium also. So that kind of data should not be left uncorrected. If by some reason it is altered here, for example, then there should be a mechanism, or there should be a way in which the altered data is being corrected. For example, when we transmit data in a long distance medium, when we transmit through a medium or a cable, a certain level, after so many distance, so much distance, there is something called attenuation. The signals, electrical signals we are sending after traveling for a certain distance becomes heat. Instead of being electrical signals, it converts itself to heat. So that has to be taken care of. This heat, before it dissipates, it disappears as heat, and which is not understandable by the receiving devices, it should be converted back into electrical signals and then accordingly transmitted. So there is bound to be some kind of alteration in a transmission that should be corrected. So if it is left uncorrected, there will be no communication. Then the next thing is that data must be delivered on time. So the system must deliver data in a timely manner. Data delivered late in most cases can be useless. For example, in case of video and audio, timely delivery means delivering data as they produce in the same order. For example, when you watch a TV movie or something, audio visual sequence. Now, if the sequence has some kind of time sequence, so if it is what has to come first should come first, what is to come last should come last. It should not be that everything goes random and then you are seeing randomly, then it is going to be a problem, because when you are seeing things randomly, then your sequence will not be useful. Okay, for example, a person is running from point A in your video from point A to point B, so that sequence has to be maintained. For example, you see the arrival first and then you see the starting of the person running, then that is not something which you will be able to process it. So therefore, the timeliness is very important. The sequence in which the audio visuals are presented should be in proper sequence. In other words, it is also called real-time transmission. The same thing with audio also. When you listen to song, it should begin with the beginning and continuously played, and then it should end with where it's supposed to end. Okay, then the next important thing is jitter is very important. Now, jitter is when the data arrives, or data here in this case we are using, instead of data we are using packets. Okay, so when the packets arrive in different times, for example, like the uneven delay in the, sometimes you see a movie from a DVD or something, and if there are too many scratches on the DVD, you see that some images are, it gets frozen while the rest still plays. Sometimes the whole thing gets stopped. Okay, so those kind of things should be avoided. So when a video is being, for example, is video packets are sent 30 frames per second, and the receiver receives it in 20 frames per second, then there is a problem. So it can be the reverse also. The sender sends can send only 20 frames per second, but at the receiving end, it's capable of receiving at 30 frames per second, then there should not be a problem. But the problem is when you are transmitting in 30 frames per second, and then at the receiving end it is only played in 20 frames per second, then there's going to be jitter. So these are some of the things that is important in the effective communication of data. All right. Now, let us come to the components. Components of data communication. Is this visible? Is the diagram visible or not?
Half, sir.
Okay, let me try to move it. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I think now everything's visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, now there are different components of communication. As you can see from here, that communication components include messages, it has the sender, it has a receiver, and it has a transmission medium. So these are the four basic components of data transmission. Okay, so data communication. Now, if you look at this, a message may be in the form of text or in the form of numbers or in the form of pictures or in the form of audio, video. Okay, and we are just giving some of those things. So messages can be in so many forms. Now, that is one component. Okay, then this is the message. Okay, then we have the sender. Here we have it, the sender. The sender can be what? The sender can be a computer, or it can be a telephone, or it can be a video camera, etc. So that can be the sender. Then we have the receiver. The receiver can be what? It also can be a computer, or some form of workstation, telephone or mobile phone, or a television set. Okay, so these are some of the possible receiver. Sender and receiver are not limited to this list only. I'm just giving you as an example. So it can be anything that is able to receive, or any devices which is able to receive data, and any devices that can send or transmit data. So that can be a sender. Now we have the transmission medium. So the medium of transmission can be cables. If it is cable, it could be twisted pair wires, or it can be coaxial cables, or these days fiber optics are more popular, so it could be fiber optic cables, or it can be wireless in the form of a radio wave. Okay, so these can be the medium, but as you can see, that those are the components of different components of the data transmission. Now, and with this diagram, you see that there are other things also. In this case, we are saying that there is a rule 1, rule 2, rule 3. The same way at the receiving end also, you have rule 1, rule 2, and rule 3, and rule n, in the sense that there can be any number of rules. So now, what happened is that in order to have the communication, okay, in order to have communication, I forgot to mention something here. You need to have protocol. Okay, forgot to type it there. So you need to have protocol. So without this protocol is what? Protocols are rules. Rule 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and n number of rules, which is used to establish or used to have a communication between the sender and the receiver. So the fifth component, or most probably the most important component, is the protocol. Now, protocol is a set of rules, as we have seen it here. It's n number of rules that helps, that governs, okay, that governs, or that decides how data communication will take place between the sender and the receiver. So it is an agreement between these two devices, the sender and the receiver, with an agreement on how they will be communicating or transmitting the data between them. So without a protocol, two devices cannot be connected. Okay, cannot be communicated. It's just like somebody is speaking somebody is speaking English only, and the other person is speaking only Hindi. Okay, so meaning that one person knows only English and the other person know only Hindi, and there will be no communication between these two person. It will be impossible to communicate between these two person because one speaks only Hindi, the other speak only English. There cannot be a communication. So in other words, communication is like the communication medium or the language through which the sender and the receiver or the devices can communicate. For example, if we say the two person has to communicate, they both speak, say, Hindi. Their common language is Hindi. Then we can have communication between the two. Okay. So in this case, this is the media, the protocol or the code through which they will be communicating. Hindi is a code through which the two will be communicating. So these are the different components of data communication. We have message, we have sender, we have receiver, we have transmission medium, then we have the protocols. Now let us come to the next, that is data representation. This is a slightly complex compared to the other components. So data representation means that how data is being represented, how we represent data in order so that we are able to transmit between devices. Now we have different data comes in different formats. As we have said earlier, it comes in the form of text, numbers, in the form of images, audio, video, and so on. So it comes in different formats. But all data, the computer is able to transmit as electrical signals only, which means that the computer is able to understand only two things, that is on and off. As an electrical device, it is able to understand on and off, or high and low voltage. Okay, so the computer is able to understand on and off, or high or low voltage, which is binary in the sense that you cannot have somewhere between half on or half off. It has to be discretely between on and off. So if the computer is able to understand only on and off or high or low voltage, then it is also able to transmit in the form of on and off or high or low voltage. So therefore, all data, text, number, images, audio, video, all of these things has to be converted into high or low voltage. Okay, which we call it binary. So to make the computer process text, images, audio, and video, it must be converted into a series of ones and zeros. That is on and off or high or low voltage. So that is why it is necessary to have data representation. Any form of data should be represented or should be converted into ones and zeros. Now, different formats, text has different representation, numbers have different representation, images have different representation, and so on. Now, let us see how texts are represented, the representation of text. For example, that the character you type on the keyboard appears on the screen. As you type, whatever you type on the keyboard will appear on the screen. So what happened is that your key press, the key press is being, this is, I think some part is not visible, right? Let me try to bring it. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
All right. I think this is better. So some part. Okay. Where are we? Okay. The key press. Whenever you press a key, that key press is converted into binary numbers. All right. So your key, the press, the key, I mean the key in the keyboard, okay, that you press is converted into binary numbers. So that is why you are able to see whatever you press and the key appearing on the screen. So in the process before it appear, it is converted into the key that you press is converted into binary numbers. Now the computer used in order to convert these things into binary numbers, the computer used some form of codes, okay, codes to convert text characters into binary. So among these codes, American Standard Code for Information Interchange is, or in short, it is also known as ASCII. So ASCII is one such code, one such standard code which is used to convert characters into binary numbers. Now, if you look at this table here, okay, the small letter A in binary, it is 011000001. So this is equivalent in decimal number or binary number. This is the equivalent of the number 97. Now the small letter B, remember, small and big letters have different binary representation. So according to ASCII code, the small letter B, the binary number is 0110010, and the decimal number equivalent is 98. Similarly with C also. So this is how the codes, binary codes, the way ASCII is codifying using binary, that its character will be represented in this with this binary numbers. So ASCII can represent around 128 characters. Okay, so when you can represent 128 characters, you can accommodate almost every English alphabet or English. To write English words is enough. But however, 128 is not sufficient. It is sufficient only for English, but it is not sufficient to represent Russian language, Hindi, Sanskrit, and so on. So other different languages to represent them is also necessary. Therefore, the standard code called Unicode is used to represent so many other languages. Now, when it comes to numbers, numbers representation is different. Codes like ASCII is not used to represent number. Why? Because numbers are directly converted into binary numbers so that it simplifies mathematical operation. Because when we are using numbers, then they are not characters. We are supposed to be able to do some kind of calculation, just like we do. So it is directly converted into binary numbers so that mathematical operations can be performed. So that is why this direct conversion is there. So no code is used in to represent numbers. Then let us come to images. Okay, representation of images. So images are also converted into binary numbers. When you convert binary images into binary numbers, it essentially becomes a digital image. Now, if you look at this picture, Digital images are made up of pictures. That means digital images constitute this box. For example, this one is made to look like a house. Okay, so there are so many different boxes. As this line is drawn like this diagonally, and then this line is drawn vertically. These two lines are drawn vertically. So it follows that box. It is within that box. So each box is called a pixel. Now, its pixel is represented with some kind of binary. Suppose this is the image on the left hand side. This is the image that we see on the screen. Now, for a black and white, if we represent black as 1 and white as 0 or on, black as 1 on or high, black white as 0 or off, then every pixel square, that means every square of this, okay, every square will be represented with zeros and ones. So this particular picture forms a grid like this on the right hand side. So the white area is 1, okay, this every pixel in white color is in 1. Here we cannot see it because I think the numbers are in black, that's why it's not visible. Here it should be 1. Let me just make it. Okay. So these are 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay. So these black ones are all 1, 1, 1. Okay, so as you can see that every pixel is represented wherever the value is binary 0, then it is white. Wherever the binary binary number 1, it is black. So that way we have the pictures converted into binaries, which is the only form in which the computer can understand. So the size of the picture, right, is specified accordingly. The image will be in the sense that, you know, how many grid is there, this picture, how many grid will be. Okay. For example, this picture, this example has 9 pixels across, that means this way, and then we have 8 pixels downward. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Similarly, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 pixels across and 8 pixels down. So all images are not in black and white. This life is not that simple. So there are color images. So when it comes to color images require more binary bits to represent its picture. For example, 00 is white, 01 is blue, and 10 is green, 11 is red. Then we have a 4 color combination. Now, if that this is in binary, when you have 2 digits like this, this is called 2 bits. 00, 01, 10, and 11. So since it is 2 numbers only, I cannot write 0, 2, 0, 3, all of those things will not come. It will be 0 and 0, 1 only. So I can have 1, 2, 3, 4 combinations. So if there is 2 bits, okay, then 0, 0, 2, 0, 1, we can have 4 combinations possible. Similarly, if we have 3 bits, that is 0, 0, 0, 2, 1, 1, 1, we can have 8 color combinations. So if we have 4 bits per pixel, that is in one picture, that is in one of this box, in one of this box is being represented by 4 bits, that means 0, 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1, 1, we can have 16 color combinations. So like that, the bits per pixel in one box, the bits in one box, can be increased. It can go up to 6, 8, and so on. So then we will have more color combination. And the more we have, the more color we have, the more clearer the picture will be. Okay. Now let us come to image quality. That has to do something with the resolution. Now, if you look at this image quality, the quality is determined by the resolution of the image. What is the resolution? That is how dense the pixels are put together. Okay, as simple as that. That means I have a picture of a person. Now I can have only 4 pixels, 1, 2, 3, 4. Or I can have so many pixels, so many lines. Okay, so there, in this case, the number of pixels is more. Then that means if the number of pixels is more, the resolution, okay, the resolution is higher. Now, if the resolution is higher, to represent higher, then the quality of the picture also is better. For example, the quality of the picture with high resolution, you see that when you expand it, when you zoom it, that it doesn't get pixelated. Pixelated in the sense means it becomes like those lines that we see. Let me show you. These kind of lines, all right? These kind of lines that we see in this picture, these are pixelated. These are unsmooth. This is no longer smooth. Okay, so now if the resolution is high, that means you have more picture. The number of pixels is much higher. Okay, higher resolution, more pixel per inch. It looks smoother, and even when it is zoom also, it still looks smoother. So that is why the image quality, as we said, is determined by the resolution. So this is a simple understanding of how image is represented. Now let us come to audio representation. Audio is usually captured in microphone and then converted into digital signals. Okay, so when you are capturing it, usually it is in analog form, and then when you want to convert it to binary numbers, that will be in digital form. So analog to digital converter samples the audio. This is one example of how audio is represented. Audio when it is when analog to digital conversion is taking place, audio is sampled in the form of audio waves at regular interval. This is an example. For example, I made a small cracking sound in 1 millisecond, for example. That is the time. Okay, this is the time, this is the value. Now that small sound is recorded, and the next sound is recorded, next sound is recorded. So when you play this in sequence, then it can make up a speech, it can make up a music, and so on. So every one of this periodic samples can be, every one can be converted into the nearest whole number. This one, what is the value at this point? What is the value? It is somewhere between 6 and 5. So that can be converted into binary numbers. Similarly, between 1 and 2, it is somewhere between 7 and 8. So that value can also be converted into binary values. For example, if this value can be 1000, and the next one can be 011, and so on. Okay, that way its wave can be converted, and then we can have numbers. Now we can have audios which can be processed, which can be communicated by the computer system or the data communication system. Now, when we come to audio, video representation, you see that video can be a continuous entity as a recording, as in the recording, or it can be broadcasted directly from the video camera. It can also be a combination of images, okay, ranges. Now, when we say the first one, continuous entity, means that as you record, it just flows it. And then when you broadcast it directly from a video camera, as you record it this way, so the flow also goes this way. Similarly, it can be a combination of images arranged in the idea, arranged to convey the idea of motion, as in cartoon pictures, for example. In cartoon pictures, here the character is here. After the next second, the character is here. And the next second, the character is here. The same character is here. So when you play from this to this, it gives you the idea that this particular is starting from one position, 1, 2, 3, 4. It gives you the notion, or it gives you an idea of motion. That the brain, your brain process that this character is moving towards this side. So that is one way of that frame by frame representation of images. In this case, what happened is that every frame will be treated like an image, okay, an image file. So it gives you, but still, combination of so much image give you the idea of motion. So video can be converted from analog to digital signals, or it can be converted from digital to analog. Now, the next thing is about the data flow. Data flow, there are three ways in which the data flow between two devices. Okay, communication can take place between two devices. When communication takes place between two devices, then it can flow in three different ways. Let me just so those things are, you have simplex, then you have half duplex, and you have full duplex. Now, when the data flows, okay, between two devices, for example, this is a computer. Imagine that this is your computer. It's not very clear. Then this is your monitor. Now, between the computer and the monitor, whatever you see in the monitor is sent by the computer, okay, by the computer to the monitor. That's why you see it. Without the computer sending the visuals to the monitor, you will not have anything to be seen. Okay, usually your monitor alone cannot show anything, but it is the computer that shows things on your monitor. So this communication normally is one direction. The flow of data is only from computer to the monitor. Okay, it is not from the monitor to the computer, unless of course your monitor is that's capable, okay? Or let us say in today's words, touch screen. If your monitor is a touch screen system, then it can send it this way. But if it is not touch screen, okay, then the direction in which the data flow is one direction. That is called simplex, okay? Data flow, when it flows only in one direction, it is called simplex. Now we have half duplex. For example, I think one good example will be police walkie-talkie. I think many of you must have seen that traffic police using walkie-talkie, where they speak, and then they press a key, they speak on the walkie-talkie, and then they say over. When they release it, the other person on the other end can press a key and then say whatever they have to say and say over and then release it. So the idea that they say over is that they are saying that I have released a key. Now you can speak. So that is both direction. Okay, they can, these A devices can talk to B devices, but not at the same time. When A is speaking, B cannot speak. And when B is speaking, A has to wait, A has to listen. So that is one direction at a time. That is called half duplex. Data flow in this case is half duplex. Now we also have full duplex. So full duplex is when data is between running between both the station at the same time. For example, when you are speaking to your friends using your mobile phone, both of you can speak at the same time. You and your friend can speak at the same time and don't listen to each other. That happens many times when we are quarreling over phone. Then nobody listens, both sides speaks. So I'm not saying that we have to do that, but that is possibility that the devices, the technology allows that two people can speak at the same time. That is what we call it, full duplex. So these are the three ways in which data flow. One is simplex, two is half duplex, three is full duplex. All right, with this, we have come to the end of this lecture. I hope everyone understood what is being said, and we will continue with the next class in the coming days. Thank you so much.